So this is the moment of truth, the first flight outside of my garden with my modified joystick for the controller to hopefully give me the old tripod mode back, but maybe something even better. You know what? I think it's working.
Hold on. I think we need to pause just there because I am getting ahead of myself in this story. I think we need to go back a few weeks to my review of the DJI Air 2S. Well, actually, it started a few years before that in my quest for the one single flying camera. But it was the Air 2S in particular that was the catalyst for all of this that followed.
And maybe, just maybe, this was the one he'd been waiting for.
If you haven't seen that video yet, then you really should, as it's one of my very best reviews. And it also give you a better backstory for this video. Whilst this does mainly feature the Air 2S, it's also relevant to the other recent Mavic and Mini drones. The Air 2S is almost my favorite drone that they make. It ties with the Mavic 2 Pro, and in a number of ways surpasses it. It's got so much going for it, but it's let down really badly with a major change that they brought in the way that you control the drone. Tripod mode has gone. In fact, it was taken away a year ago with the Mavic Air 2, but it was still called that with the initial drones that shipped. It just didn't operate the same way. And with the Mini 2, all labeled as the massively inferior cine smooth mode. You see, tripod mode slowed the drone down to a maximum speed of 1 meter a second. This made doing really precise super controlled shots possible. It made for, and I really hesitate to use this word, but I'm gonna, cinematic shots. I can justify using it because I use this mode to mimic classic cinematic movement with things like dolly and crane shots. Now, cine smooth mode has a maximum speed of 5 meters a second. This is not slow. In fact, after much good Will Hunting-esque calculations, I worked out that the 5 meters a second speed of cine smooth mode was 5 times faster than the 1 meter a second of tripod mode. Utter madness. You can still get slow shots with cine smooth, as it is slower than normal mode, but it's not slow enough. The sticks are way more sensitive than they were in tripod mode, so it's much harder to replicate those classic camera moves, and also for when I want to fly backwards through everything that I see. It's way too easy to accidentally move the sticks a little bit too much, resulting in a shot that wasn't quite what you intended. In my review, I said it would be great if they could bring out new firmware that gave us the ability to dial in the maximum speed, but I'm not optimistic about this happening. As I like to make things overly complicated for myself, I decided to add another challenge at the same time. And that is a way to combat the horrendous oversharpening that the video suffers from in most of DJI's drones. The Air 2S actually isn't anywhere near as bad as the others. The D-Log and HLG modes, they both have reduced oversharpening, but it's still got a bit too much. I only shoot with D-Log now, by the way. The HLG I find too noisy in the shadows. And the standard mode is awful, and that's the mode you need to use for things like the master shots and the zoom modes. The Mavic Air, Air 2, Mini, Mini 2, they've all got the same ugly oversharpening. Until now, I've had to soften the image in post. Now that's far from an ideal solution because I don't actually want the video to be soft. I still want detail, I just don't want over-sharpened ugliness. You see, sharpness and detail are two very different things. The only thing I could think of was to try some diffusion filters. In fact, I don't know why I didn't think of this ages ago. After all, sometimes I use these on my main cameras because of the unique look that they can give you. So I had a look online, and I was shocked that not one single filter manufacturer made any. The Mavic Pro and 2 Pro have image controls to adjust your sharpness, and also adjust the sensitivity of your controls to make them less responsive. Unfortunately, all the drones DJI have released since then do not have either of these functions. So the only option was to find solutions myself. A way to slow the joysticks down and to make my own diffusion filters for the drones. Diffusion filters disrupt the light path, breaking up the concentration of light passing through using different sorts of textures or patterns in the glass of the filter. In a nice high quality filter that isn't too specialized, this will not blur the image, but make today's rather over detailed video look more pleasing and natural, especially on people's faces. They also have a pleasing effect on highlights, giving a nicer spread, making them less harsh. I'm sure you got some Vaseline in your bedside drawer, and using that for diffusion is super old school. I did in fact use a tiny amount on one of the ND filters in my Air2S review, but it was so minimal you could barely tell. But minimal is the key if you are going to use Vaseline. Hairspray can work well as long as you don't overdo it and the droplets aren't too big. Always apply anything like this to the rear of the filter. Never spray directly onto them. Catch the droplets from the spray when they're floating in the air. Start with two, maybe three passes. Try it out and then add more if needed. I've tried out the hairspray trick before and it can work well, but I was using normal size filters. There was absolutely no science behind this whatsoever. I was just doing this visually. By the way, these droplets won't rub off easily. They are stuck on there, which is good. To remove the droplets, you simply soak them in water. Now I was happy with the various diffusion filters that I'd made. I had to tackle the really challenging part, the tripod mode fix. To give me some inspiration, I had a look on Skillshare, the sponsor of this video, to see if there were any DIY courses that covered making actual things. And I found this class from Mark Fauenfelder, who, amongst many other things, is the founder editor-in-chief of Make magazine.
I'm going to show students how to come up with ideas, the tools that they need, the components that they need, what to do if they get stuck, and how to take their project to the next level.
I love Skillshare for this. There's always something that gives me that little push and inspiration that I need from their thousands of classes which cover so many different topics. Click the link in the description below to sign up for a free trial. After that, it's about $10 a month. So armed with this new inspiration, I started work on what turned out to be something a lot more challenging than I expected it to be. So I needed to reduce the travel of the stick so I couldn't reach the top speed of 5 meters a second. But the actual movement isn't linear. I needed to add resistance, not friction. It needed to be something soft. The lip on the controller was going to be the key. This was what I would need to push up against to create some resistance. So I bought washers, lots of them. Rubber ones, nylon ones, brass ones, and lots of O-rings. And these are the ones which turned out to be really key for creating that resistance. I tried numerous different sizes and shapes to try and achieve this ideal resistance. I also bought these extendable sticks, and these proved to be really important to my more successful attempts. I thought I nailed it quite quickly with this design. That was until I tried to take off in the garden. And then I realized I couldn't move the joysticks to the takeoff positions. I could only take off and land with the app, which is not a good idea. What I was making needed to be safe. In fact, this test made me realize I needed to find a way to not just add resistance, but also be able to go to full speed really quickly. So not switching joysticks. On some of my designs, the rubber would get a little bit caught on the lip, which is not a good idea if you are trying to go fast quickly. So this is what I came up with. I used a combination of brass and hard rubber washers to create a base. The rubber washer had a small hole for the joystick to go through. On the bottom, I glued a 20mm O-ring to the rubber washer, which gave me the right amount of resistance when pushed up against the lip of that controller. That lip has a diameter of about 25mm. But I did, however, use a 28mm O-ring glued onto a thin brass washer, and this stopped the smaller O-ring getting caught on the lip. Whilst this design did work with the standard joysticks, it way better with the extended ones. With the standard ones, I could take off and get close to full acceleration, but I had to push quite forcefully to achieve this. With the extended sticks, when I pushed harder, the rubber moved up the stick slightly, and it made it way easier to go to full speed. Then when I wanted to go back to full slow mode, I just simply pushed the rubber down slightly to go back into place. So after all of that with the joysticks and the diffusion filters, it was time for my first outing to see just how well they both worked. Which brings us neatly back to the beginning of this video. It took some getting used to, as I had to push a little bit harder on the controls than I normally would, otherwise the drone would barely move. When I pushed the joysticks, the amount I was using to get something like tripod mode in the new Cine Smooth mode, I was barely getting 0.1 meters a second, but it was pretty easy to adapt how I used the joysticks. When I pushed up as far as I could without putting too much pressure on the O-ring, I was getting about 0.5 meters a second. And with a little bit more pressure, I could get around 1 meter a second. Tripod mode. What I found was easier than putting too much pressure onto the joysticks in this situation was actually just to switch to normal mode, and I was able to get around 1 meter a second. So I now not only had tripod mode, but I had monopod mode. No, it doesn't work. Well, both those names are stupid anyway. Tripods don't move, after all, and CineSmooth is a good name. It just needs to be made to work like tripod mode. But also with the option to go faster by changing the speed in the menu, because 5 meters a second can actually be pretty useful at times.
If you are thinking about giving this a try and making your own set of joysticks for this lovely super slow control, then great. But just remember the key safety aspects. We do need to be able to go fast and react when needed. And we don't want any of the rubber to get stuck at all, and no unscrewing of joysticks, any of that sort of stuff. Just please make sure you are safe. And the other thing is the yaw control. You can change that in the menu to be much, much slower. The rubber will add resistance, so you might need to adjust that. Anyway, hopefully DJI can make all of this completely pointless with a firmware update, and I really hope they do. But maybe let me get the video up first. I'm pretty happy with this first test. I think it's gone pretty well. I think the controls that I've modified are definitely better. It's not perfect, but it's certainly better than it was. I now have tripod mode. In fact, I have slower than tripod mode, and that's wonderful. And I can easily go to the normal speed as well. And that is exactly what I want for my drone. I want full control. So definitely happy with that. I think I could still do a few more refinements. And then there's the diffusion filters. It's hard to say because I haven't looked back at the footage yet, but from my tests that I've done so far, I think they're good. Are they as good as a real diffusion filter? No. But hopefully the manufacturers will see this and go, yeah, we should make some of those. Otherwise, hairspray sales are gonna be going up through the roof. Fair enough, really, because it works pretty well.